China's GDP has quadrupled in the last 15 years. Researchers are asking why. This year, I went to China and interviewed several high school students. And through this interview, I hope to add my own piece to the answer. With this interview, I learned about Chinese students' studies, lives, even what they think about, and also their plans for the future. I visited and interviewed students in two public high schools in the city of Dalian, a northeastern port city about the same latitude as New York City or Boston. The two high schools, named Dalian Yiming High School and Dalian 20th High School, are in the Dalian Top 5, which are competitively tested for admission. The huge campuses contain numerous facilities. When I stepped into Yiming, huge embossed words greeted me with the slogan, Nation, Future, Pride. And every classroom hallway hung rows of words saying, self-motivation, self-improvement, innovation, triumph. In a competitive environment like China, the goal of everyone in the schools, be it the teachers, the students, the staff, is to have the students attend the best universities possible. In front of 20th High, a large bulletin board displays the names of last year's students who were accepted into top universities. Among these universities, I saw some American universities. Chinese students can choose from two different sets of classes, the liberal arts or the sciences. So how do they actually study? I asked one student what kinds of homework they have. In China, the students spend most of their time doing schoolwork.
I think you must be very free in America or other place. But in China, we have lots of homework to do every day. We might study until 10:20 in the evening.
However, they still have a variety of extracurricular activities.
Clubs，不过比较少。我们需要比较活跃的clubs，比如说像街舞，健美操，再就是美术吧。然后这些比较活跃，像街舞，他们经常训练，然后 每次比如说一些篝火晚会啊，什么新年晚会啊，他们都会上台表演。然后像我们健美操是需要参加大连市的比赛，或者是就是参加全国比赛。不过我觉得可能很多家长是不愿意参加，怕耽误学习。
我们自己的时间很少，比如说正课的时间非常非常多。然后如果你经过想参加这些课外活动，大部分都是自习课的时间。但自习课相对来说比较少，然后所以说很少有机会能够参加。
Generally, every student hoping to get into college needs to take a national college admissions test. It's given for 3 days in early July of the last year of high school and covers certain subjects studied in school. For students studying math and science, the subjects are math, Chinese, English, physics, chemistry, and biology.For the liberal arts students, subjects include math, English, Chinese, history, geography, and politics. These subjects are scored for a total of 750 points. Each college has its own admissions score line. Only students who pass this score line can be accepted into the college.
三月份的时候，要参加一个叫学业水平测试。然后这个学业水平测试是9门都要考试。然后在你拿到一定成绩之后，你才允许就是参加高考。然后高考是一个很累的事情。
考大学，一般就是有保送或者是参加考试。保送一般就是。在奥林匹克竞赛上获得特别好的成绩，然后就有可能是保送，或者是你获得一等奖，然后参加学校一个保送考试，然后这些考过的话就不用参加那个像 SAT 这种考试，就是直接可以被学校录取。当然那个考试需要有笔试还有面试，还有就是校长推荐，就是你在学校平日的成绩特别好的话，校长可以给你推荐，然后你就是参加面试再加参加笔试，如果通过的话也就是不用参加高考了，大部分人还得是参加高考。高考是一年整一次，不像 SAT 一年很多次。然后你要是考不好的话，只能第二年，就是间隔的时间有点太长。通过成绩排名，然后看你报的哪个学校录取，然后有一个分数线，然后你够那分数线，你就可以上；不够你就上不了，你就选别的学校。这个分儿特别重要，就看这个分儿你能不能上。然后如果你有特长，像我就是。我有小提琴特长，然后你就可以去考。如果他觉得你很好的话，他也可以给你加分。然后我觉得那个压力还是比较大的，因为你但不考不好的话，你就很可能上不了想去的那个大学。
在高一的时候，是已经让我们去填写一下将来想考哪所大学的意愿了。
那么这个自主招生呢，主要他们也是说来了，也是重在考生，也是重在考生。你看我大学到你的学校来招生，你过了我们大学的分数线了以后，我感觉你这个孩子各方面能力还比较不错，只要你考大学过程中能考到一本线，我就要你，这也是一种方法。但是中国这块主要还是通过这个高考，通过高考来录取比较好的大学。你像清华大学，清华大学看什么？主要是看，那么这个能力这块也挺重视的。你比方说打个比方，你是好学生，是省里的优秀学生，省里的三好学生，省里优秀学生，这都可能讲，都要讲实的。
During my visit, I had the opportunity to witness the weekly flag raising ceremony.
进步，走！
I've also had a chance.To talk with a member of the student council.
我们这儿有那个，有分的，就是首先有一个主席团，就是整个学生会的领导班子，大约有4到5人。这个领导班子管着，下面管理着不同的部门，就是包括体育部，就是负责体育比赛或者一些重大活动的。后勤就是比如说帮忙搬个桌子，也有文艺部，他们负责比如说演出的导演，还有秘书处，他们 就是做 secretary 他们这样的一些事。高中之后参加学生会，就是亲自自己跟自己的同伴从这个像活动的策划到执行，每一个环节都需要我们自己来思考，然后就是锻炼了自己的一些创造性，也提高了一些自己执行的能力吧。
In the US, I'm part of a first tech challenge robotics team. And one time during a robotics competition in New York City, I met a judge who, after examining my team's robot, asked me a question. Do you want to be a banker or an engineer in the future? He added that bankers do nothing and get everything, while engineers do everything and get very little.I asked the same question to Chinese high school students.
我觉得还是当 engineer 比较好。我将来可能要想从事 IT 方面工作。
我喜欢 banker。
将来喜欢从事 engineering， 因为我比较喜欢数理化这理科这方面的东西，然后对这个engineering 比较感兴趣。
我觉得我不能想到 engineer 这样的，我比较感兴趣的方面是 agriculture， 那个农业方面的。
我想做一个 engineer 这样，但是同时我也想，挣很多钱，既有很多的付出，然后又有很高的回报，这也是我想做。
I saw a slogan.On the campus of 20th High that best summarized China's attitude on education. A nation's future is determined not on the battlefield, but rather in every classroom. Reporting for Teen Kids News, I'm Qingyang Chen.